Experiment number 16. Aim: to measure the taper angle of given machined job piece by using sine bar with surface plate and gauge blocks. Apparatus: sine bar, surface plate and gauge block. Introduction: sine bar. It is used either to measure angles more precisely than a bevel protractor or for locating any work to a given angle Q within very close limits. It is generally used in conjunction with slip gauge and surface plate. A sine bar consists hardened and ground steel bar which is stepped at the ends. A roller is fastened in each step with a screw. A sine bar is specified by the distance between the centers of two rolls. Some holes are drilled in the body of the sine bar in order to reduce the weight and to facilitate handling. Surface plate. It is made of grey cast iron in various sizes. It is usually a square or rectangular and has the top and the adjacent four edges very accurately machined and scraped to form a true flat surface and the brought in a square. It is placed horizontally on a firm support whose working height is about 800 mm from the floor. It is to check the trueness of flat surface and to copy the master surface on a work. A thin coating of red lead mixed with oil is spread evenly over the surface plate. The work to be tested is cleaned, placed on the plate and gently moved along it. The parts which come in contact with red lead are marked and show where more metal has to be removed. The surface plate are made in two grades of accuracy, that is A and B, depending upon scraping of within 0.005 mm and 0.02 mm respectively. It should be oiled and covered with a wooden cover to protect from dust when not in use. Gauge block. The slip gauges are used for checking the accuracy of measuring instrument such as micrometers, calipers, snap gauge, dial indicators, etc. These are also used for setting the sine bars for angular measurement, for accurate measurement in die manufacture and in various precision measuring machines like tool room, microscope, etc. The slip gauge consists of alloy steel or tool steel blocks of section about 30 mm by 10 mm. These are hardened before being finished to size. The slip gauges are made in the following four grades: workshop or production grade, inspection grade, calibration grade, reference grade. principle. The work having tapered top and flat base is placed on the surface plate and adjust the sign bar with the help of gauge blocks on the top of workpiece. In this way, we can determine the taper angle with sign formula. Procedure. Clean the given workpiece with sandpaper. Place the workpiece over the surface plate. Then adjust the sign bar with the gauge blocks to coincide the top surface of the work piece with the sign bar. Then determine the H1 and H2 measurement. Now apply the formula sign equal perpendicular by hypotenuse and determine the angle. In this way, we check the taper angle. The sine bar should not be used for angle greater than 60 degree because any possible error in construction is accentuated at this limit. A compound angle should not be formed by misaligning of workpiece with the sine bar. This can be avoided by attaching the sine bar and work against an angle plate. Accuracy of sine bar should be ensured. As far as possible, longer sine bar should be used since many errors are reduced by using longer sine bars.